Good evening, everyone. Today we are going to read about question tags. So here we go. I have divided the question tags into three different parts. The first one is with helping verb. With helping verb means, here you can see the helping verb will be given in the sentence itself. The main thing about the question tag is there will be only two words in the question tag, only two. The first one is helping verb and the second one is pronoun. Okay, so the first word, which is helping verb, it can be positive also, negative also. So here we go. The first question is, she is eating. When we have to add question tag, you see the sentence is positive. She is eating. If for the positive, we will give negative question tag.
What?
Isn't she? As it is positive, so we will write negative question tag. Isn't she? Going to the next one. I am not a doctor. I am not a doctor. In this sentence, you see, this sentence is negative. It means we have to give positive question tag. Not is already here, so we are not going to include not in the answer. I am not a doctor. Answer will be am I. So for the positive sentence, negative question tag, and for the negative sentence, positive question tag. Third one is, I am a teacher. I am a teacher. So in answer it should be am not. Like it was is, answer was is not. The short form is isn't. In that way, am not short form is aren't. Answer will be aren't I. And question mark is very important. One more thing, if suppose here there is any name, she is eating, suppose here it is Neha is eating, then also answer would be isn't she, because here we don't use any name, we use pronouns. If the question has noun, we are going to use pronoun instead of noun. If boy, then he, if girl, then she. Depends upon the number also. Coming to the next question, sometimes in the question there is no helping verb. In those cases, in those type of sentences, we have three options. If there is no helping verb, like is, am, are, was, were, can, may, nothing is given, then we will go with either do, does, and did. So the first question is, I play cricket. As the sentence is positive, we are going to give negative question tag. So as I said, we have only three options. In case of helping verb is not given, we have three options: do, does, and did. Did we use for the past tense? If it would be I played cricket, then we are going to use did. But this sentence is in present tense, so we will use do or does. Now coming to the pronoun, it is I. With I we don't use does, we use do. So the question is positive, question tag will be negative. Don't I? Next question, she runs fast. There is no helping verb. So we have three options again: do, does, and did. So it's present tense, that's why there will be did will be cancelled. Do and does. With the pronoun she, we always use does. That's why the answer will be doesn't she. Because the question has no negative word. No, not is not there. So we are going to use negative question tag. Okay. Third one, they don't know. Answer will be, here don't, it's negative word. So answer will be positive. Do they? They don't know. Do they? Now coming to the most confusing question tags. In some of the questions, when have, has is given, though have and has, these are the helping verbs. But sometimes we use these in the question tags and sometimes we don't use. Now let's see which are the things. She has played football. Now, here you see has, after has we have one main verb, played. V3 is given. In those cases, we will use the same helping verb. Has, as it is a positive question, so question tag will be negative. And we always use contracted form. Not, we don't write separate, we use contracted form, short forms. So, she has played football, answer will be hasn't she. Has, it will be hasn't she. Next is, they have not come here. They have not come here. Here not is already mentioned. The sentence is negative. So we are going to give positive question tag for it. And the answer would be have they and question mark after each question tag. have not and suddenly have there. Coming to the third question, she has a car. But the answer is, doesn't she? Actually, has is given, then according to that, answer should be, hasn't she? But the answer is, doesn't she? Why? There is a reason. You see, whenever have, has is there, after that, if we have any V3, after have or has, if we have V3, then we are going to use the same helping verb. But here V3 is not there. It is used as V2 here. So, in that case, see, if you change this sentence, she has a car, what will be the negative sentence for it? She doesn't have a car. Does word comes when we change it to negative. That does you have to use here. It means, if it is V2, there is no V3 after have, has, then you cannot use that as helping verb here. That is used as main verb and that is V2. So we are going to write, doesn't she? She has a car. Negative is, she doesn't have a car. Then question that will be, doesn't she? Because with she we use does. Do and did we don't use. Did is in the past tense, but this sentence is not in past. So did is cancelled. And do we cannot use with she. It is used with the plural things. Now, they have a pen. Same thing, they have a pen. Here there is no main verb. There is no V3 form. That's why with they we use do. It is not past tense, that's why did we are not using here. So it will be, don't they? As the sentence is positive, so question tag will be negative. Don't they? So, once you can do revision, if you have any question, any doubt, you can ask me in the comment box. I will answer to each question. By that time, do revision. Thank you. Have a good day.